Fans of professional wrestling have long been seen as some of the most devoted and passionate in the sports world. But a new book reveals a shocking secret. The so-called fans are, in fact, choreographed paid performers. And we are joined now from Raleigh, North Carolina, by the author of Faked, My Life as a Professional Wrestling Fan, Craig Thompson. Mr. Thompson, this is a very controversial book.
What made you decide to pull back the curtain now?
I want people to know that the fans and the audience are, you know, amazing at their craft of acting.
Well, tell me something. Is there a script?
We have all the basic beats planned ahead of time. We know in advance who we're going to be booing, what wrestlers the women are going to flash.
It sounds exhausting.
It's very hard to be able to cheer for something as ridiculous and as absurd as costumed, you know, bodybuilders flailing around and, you know, shouting ridiculous and poorly written insults. You have to have a real endurance and a real commitment.
I see. Are you actually a fan of the sport, or would you not be doing this if you weren't being paid?
No, I'm not a fan of the sport. I don't think anybody over the age of 15 is a fan of the sport. You know, without us cheering and going crazy, it would be very hard for anyone to see the event as an actual sporting event.
Right. Let me ask you, is this a full-time job for you?
Oh, yeah, absolutely it is. What we have to do is maintain a constant focus on lack of physical fitness. I have to have a bedraggled appearance. We have what's called a convenience store diet amongst the pro fan community. A lot of us mostly subsist on, you know, chips and soda.
Your book also reveals in one of its chapters the so-called tricks of the trade. You want to tell us about any of those?
Yeah, absolutely. One of them was called the soda jump and drench, where I would jump up and flip my 32-ounce jumbo soda in the air with my knee.
I've seen that.
Sending the Mountain Dew contents all over the entire aisle in the stands. It's a very complicated move.
The number of your fellow performers are not very happy about your exposing this secret.
I've gotten a couple of calls from other fans telling me that I'm going to be, you know, they're going to burn my face more severely than Kane's face was burned by his brother, The Undertaker, which is pretty terrifying. I would have to wear a mask for the rest of my life if that happened.
So then what is your next step?
Well, I'm thinking about taking on something new, perhaps becoming a professional golf fan.